The Indian chemical industry could emerge as an unlikely winner in the global trade war. While the US has been moving fast on Chinese imports, Indian companies seem to be stepping in to meet that demand. Perhaps it's already started reflecting in Balaji Amines' numbers when exports jumped to more than 90% in the last quarter. But will this trend continue? That's the question. And let's ask that to Mr. D. Ram Reddy, Joint Managing Director at Balaji Amines, joins us right now on the show. Mr. Reddy, good having you. Thanks so much for joining in. You know, I've been listening about this, or I've been hearing about this whole move of China acting upon its polluting norms for the last 4 years, and Indian companies benefiting. Now we're starting to hear yet another parody about how the trade war and the US clampdown might force countries across the world to start importing from the Indian companies. Is that true? Is that plausible? And are you already seeing signs of that if it's true?
See, actually, Indian industry, specifically in the specialty chemical industry, is getting benefit of this China environmental issues. Past four, five months, we have seen very good intake from into China from the various countries, including India. Once we used to import a lot of products from China, now the very product was started exporting to the China. That was the positive point. But we cannot take this as a granted for the future. Until otherwise, China do not take U-turn. Most of the times it has taken U-turn and withdrawn the all the regulations what they implemented. So it should not happen. Otherwise, it looks very bright for the chemical industry presently. And not only in India, see, all these days everybody was depending on China all over the world. So once, even if China takes U-turn also, the people who are depending on China were taken, started taking from India. So the India will always be there as a second supplier. It should become as a first supplier for all our country.
Okay.
So in our case also, we have seen the exports, we have seen in the first quarter almost 90% growth. If not 90, but definitely we will see 40 to 50%, definitely it should be sustainable growth in the export.
Okay. So, which was actually the question, right? I mean, we led into this discussion looking at what your previous numbers have looked like and the jump in exports that we've seen. Now, is this sustainable irrespective of the trade war? And I'm not really talking about what will happen in the next quarter or the quarter after next. Let's look at over the next 2 years. Do you believe the export opportunity is large enough for your export numbers to keep on growing, if not at 90%, then at a slightly lower number, but at a higher pace for quarter after quarter for the next few quarters?
See, we are targeting a minimum 30% of the total sales should be our exports. Presently, we have reached about 20-23%, but we are expecting minimum 30% before end of the year. We should reach to 30% of the total sales. Like what I said in earlier interviews, like we are looking for 1,000 to 1,050 crores for this current financial year ending. So there we are trying to reach this 30% targets, and with the current scenario and current trend of the export markets, we assume that yes, it should reach 28 to 30% easily.
No, but reaching 30% is one thing, Mr. Reddy. That could also happen if the other sales don't move up that much. So my question to you would be, would exports as a number, not necessarily as a percentage of your sales, move up dramatically over the next few quarters?
No, I'm talking, you see, current sales is about 800, which where I've shown you 20% growth minimum will be there in the total sales, that is 1,050. I'm talking about the growth on the exports also, proportionately little more than what is the 20% is percent. I'm talking about 30% growth in the exports.
Okay.
So in our case, what has happened, in October, we are commissioning the new plant in our subsidiary company, where we are going to produce the very special product, that is EDA, ethylene diamine, which presently nobody making in the country. And in worldwide also, there are only few people where you can count on fingers. Like that product is coming up in India, and we are expecting that all the imports will be prevented in the country, and as well as we may move some of the products to outside country also with this product. So that this current year itself, we are targeting that at least 100 crores will add it to the top line.
Very interesting. So One thing that we're seeing, Mr. Reddy, in your numbers is the uptick in operational metrics. Now, over the next 12 to 18 odd months, by virtue of this new plant, by virtue of higher exports, by virtue of a higher share of specialty chemicals, can one expect your operational margins to maybe nudge 25% and then stay there consistently? Is that a remote possibility?
If the things market allows the present trend, definitely it will reach to 25%. This current quarter we have achieved almost 22.8, nearly 23% we have achieved. If everything goes well, as I said, that the U-turn of China, so if that not happens, then definitely yes, I can say that 25% will go. There is a possibility that we are expecting maybe another positive thing by first week of this month, maybe next 2-3 weeks. We are expecting that anti-dumping will implement on one of our main product, that dimethyl formide, which we were struggling for the past 3-4 years. See, that specifically that product, we have a capacity of 30,000 tons per annum, and we were operating at 8 to 10,000 tons. In the last year also, we operated only 8 to 9,000 tons. For this product, it's not that country is not consuming. Country's consumption is about 40,000 tons for this product in India. So once this anti-dumping comes, yes, definitely, as you asked, this margins, EBITDA margins should go around 25%.
Okay. We wish you all the best. Congratulations on a very good quarter. All the best with the plant coming up as well. And all the best for the rest of the year, Mr. Reddy. Good talking to you today.